if you close your
Hello, Brownsburg High School. Thanks for watching BHS TV. Today is Monday, February 6th. I'm Parker Bowles.
And I'm Eli Johnson. And here's what's going on at BHS.
AP students, the clock is ticking on AP test registration. The deadline to access the total registration website to sign up and pay for your test is February 20th. Please ask your AP teacher for details.
On Saturday, 27 BHS students attended the annual Staats Congress Indiana German State Convention. Students spent the day at Ball State attending workshops, participating in competitions, and attending a German dance with a live band. We are very proud of these few award winners. Quiz Bowl, first place, Allie Joseph, Meg Roseman, Andrew Torres, Rachel Walters. Talent, first place, Jacob Sumner. Spelling Bee, first place, Adam Sieferman. Reading, first place, Tim Heidegger. Poem Recitation, second place, Andrew Torres. Spelling Bee, second place, Anna Ganagi. Written Diction, third place, Andrew Torres. Reading, third place, Rachel Walters. Listening, third place, Andrew Torres. Additionally, junior Allie Joseph was elected vice president of the Indiana Association of Students of German, and Andrew Torres was chosen to serve on the board of this state organization. They will plan and help Staats Congress 2018.
The BHS Yearbook Club will be hosting a tournament starting on Monday, February 13th at 7:10 a.m. in Mrs. Cattaneo's room. Be sure to bring a partner if you are interested in participating. The winners will receive a prize.
The annual Valentine flower sale is going on from February 7th to the 13th. You can purchase a flower for $2 for a friend or a staff member during your lunch period. All money goes towards scholarship fundraising and PayPal is available. Flowers will be delivered on February 14th.
Do you have a sweet tooth in the morning before school? BHS HOSA has your problem solved. HOSA is selling Ozark Delight Lollipops for only $1 from 7:10 to 7:45 each morning this week outside the auditorium and in the Senior Academy Commons. There are 26 flavors to choose from, including wild cherry, watermelon, raspberry lemonade, and sour green apple.
The National Art Honor Society will be selling Valentine's Day cards on February 9th and 10th at lunch, ranging from $1 to $3. The more expensive cards come with different treats that will be related to the card, and then they will be delivered on February 14th.
It is now February, and the renowned Black History Month has already commenced. Here's our own Weston Pinnock on the story.
All of us are aware that Black History Month, also known as African American History Month, is currently in session. Around the time when it was only recognized as a week long, the single week was hardly recognized due to the lack of African American history being published in school textbooks. And the shortcoming of this history being taught, it wasn't until about 100 years after the nation's founding that this was quickly changed. After this, many never thought of the week would eventually evolve into an entire month. But over time, it was finally established when many finally took notice that the entire month of February was a significant time for African American figures that rewrote their history and critical events occurring, such as the 15th Amendment was passed, granting blacks the right to vote, also known as suffrage, and the first black U.S. Senator, Hiram R. Revels, took his oath to office. Following these notable African American milestones, the month was observed by every president since 1976. After the presidential observances, we continue to celebrate the month in the past, the present, and the unsuspecting future. This is Weston Pinnock, BHS TV.
Thank you, Weston, for the awesome story about Black History Month.
And now it's time for sports. Hey, Kieran, what do you have for us today?
Hey, guys. It's been a very exciting and successful weekend for BHS Sports. Congrats to the Brownsburg wrestling team on their second consecutive regional championship. The team crushed the competition in setting a school record, advancing 12 wrestlers to semi-state in Evansville next weekend. Regional champions were Ty Mills, Blake Mulkey, Brayton Lee, Nathan Walton. Other wrestlers advancing were Drake Campbell, Evan Lawhead, Drew Kreitzer, Ryan Bigelow, Zach Myers, Anthony Cicerelli, Isaac McCormick, and Rookie Clark. Nice job, guys. Wrestling State Finals t-shirts are now on sale and can be purchased from Coach Snyder or Coach Thompson. The cost is $10 for a short sleeve and $15 for a long sleeve. Only cash will be accepted. The shirt will include each wrestler's name that qualifies for state, along with the feature of that person on one of the Bulldogs. After defeating Terre Haute North on Friday, the girls' basketball team played in the sectional finals against Mooresville on Saturday. After trailing by two at the half, the Dogs came out strong in the third quarter and took the lead. Mooresville responded and sent the game into overtime. The OT was all Dogs as they outscored the Pioneers 12-3 and secured the sectional championship. Riley Olmsted led the way with 30 points and 7 rebounds. The Dogs will play Pike in the regional semifinals this Saturday. That game starts at noon at Decatur Central. And congrats to the girls' swimming and diving team, who won their fourth consecutive team sectional title. The ladies outscored the runner-ups by over 200 points on their way to victory. Ladies advancing to regionals for the Dogs included Danielle Leclerc, Hannah Truax, and diving. The ladies winning events and advancing to state championships include Logan Rapogel in the 200 IM and 500 free, Jenny Dressen in the 100 back, and medley relay team of Jenny Dressen, Madison Meringer, Bailey LaPaul, and Abby Callis, and the 400 free relay team of Bailey LaPaul, Miranda Peak, Julie Claude Felcher, and Logan Rapogel. Nice job, ladies. That's all for today. Back over to you guys.
Thanks, Karen. That's all we got for you today, BHS.
Have a great day. We will see you on Wednesday.